歡迎大家睇呢條片啊！咁今日呢條片就繼續講 ANOVA 啦，但今次就會講第二個 experimental design， 就係呢個 randomized block design experiment。咁我哋上一條片 focus 嘅 case 係 completely randomized 嘅 design experiment 啦。咁即係話其實 treatment 咧就係 randomly assigned to 我哋嘅 experimental units 嘅。係啦，咁有興趣就可以睇翻上一條 ANOVA 嘅片啦。咁但我哋諗下呢個 design 咪幾時都啱用呢？如果我哋嘅個 experimental units 係 heterogeneous， 即係有分別嘅時候，咁啊點咧？咁我都係諗一個例子啦。好似而家我哋想試下三個唔同教學方法對考試成績嘅影響啦。係啦，咁所以嗰個教學方法就個 treatment 啦。係啦，咁我哋可唔可以用呢個 completely randomized 嘅 design？ 即係我哋可能 recruit 一班同學 randomly 咁 recruit 一班同學。跟住每人 assign 一個唔同嘅教學方法，再睇下對考試有冇影響，咁樣得唔得咧？係啦，咁有一個問題出現咗啦，就係、是、學生本身嘅 ability， 佢哋嘅 IQ 係咪一樣咧？係咁，我哋可以諗下。咁如果我哋 random 咁樣 recruit 咗一班學生，咁啊 IQ 高啲嗰個咧，嚇、一定就係會考得好啲噶嘛，係咪？即係通常都考得好啲噶嘛，係咪？咁 IQ 低啲就考得差啲咁樣啦。所以呢，我們如果用這個 random completely randomized design 的這個方法去做這個實驗呢，就可能呢會有一些 extraneous 的 factors 會影響到了。我們這個時候可以怎麼解決呢？就是透過 blocking， 就是 form homogeneous group among experimental units， 即我們將相同 IQ 的學生就 group 在一起，這樣就是這個就叫做這個 randomized block design experiment 了。咁就係 control for 一啲我哋嘅實驗唔想要嘅 factors 啦。咁啊，其實統統啲咁講咧，有兩種 randomized block design experiment 嘅 design 嘅。咁啊，就例子啦。咁第一 type 咧就係、是，好似我哋而家想試呢個 air traffic controller 嘅 stress test， 我哋就有三個 treatment 啦。係啦，咁其實咧呢度就係咧，第一個方法就係咧，每一個 controller 都會係做曬 A、B、C 三個 system 嘅。跟住再得出佢哋一個嘅分數咁樣，係啦。咁啊，第二個又會做一二三啦，第三個一二三。咁即係呢度咧，我哋就會 randomly 咁 recruit 六條友，佢六個人就會做曬一二三三樣嘢，係啦。咁啊，佢個 random 嗰個情況係點咧？就係試 A、B、C 嗰個次序就會係 randomize， 即係可能第一個就會試 B、A、C， 跟住第二個就係 A、C、B 咁樣。咁樣呢個就係嗰個 randomize 嘅地方啦。咁第二 type 應該就係正路啲嘅，咁就我哋好似我哋個例子咁樣啦，我哋就 random 咁樣 recruit 一扎學生，嗱再將佢哋做 blocking， 嗱例如跟佢哋嘅 IQ 做 blocking， 咁例如呢度每個 block 就有三個人啦，咁咧就會 randomly 咁 assign 每一個 block 入邊每一個人就會試一種方法，再去比較嘅，嗱咁呢個就係第二種做呢個 randomized。block design experiment design 嘅一個方法啦，咁我哋晏啲個例子都係會講呢個，因為呢個好似似乎就係比較易明白啲。咁繼續講落去之前，我哋可以講啲 notation 上嘅嘢。嗱，咁喺呢個例子咧，個 response 或者個 dependent variable 就係考試分數啦。嗱，即係經過呢個 teaching method 之後 ，teaching method A 之後咧，咁啊，喺第一個 block 嘅就。有個學生考咗84分啦，有個考咗86啦、86、89，咁樣用 B 方法就考85、86、87咁樣。咁 treatment 咧就係嗰個 teaching method 咧 ，A、B 同埋 C。咁咧我哋嘅 notation 就會用 J 嚟 denote 呢個 treatment 嘅。咁喺呢個例子啦，咁 treatment 就係1 to K 啦 ，K 就係總共 total treatment 嘅 number 啦，咁呢個就係3啦。咁咧我哋今次又多咗個 variable 嘅，就係呢個叫 block。block 就用 I 嚟 denote 嘅。咁啊，一去到 B 啦，咁呢度就一二三四五六，啊 B 就係 total 有幾多個 block 啦，咁呢個就係六嘅。嗱，咁啊，大家就要記住呢啲 notation 啦，係啦 ，I 同埋 J 啦。咁我哋呢個 ANOVA 嗰個 H 零都係一樣嘅，個 null hypothesis。咁 null 就係A、B、C 三個 mean 係一樣啦，即係喺 A、B、C 三個 teaching method 底下咧。我哋得到嘅 average 嘅 test score 都係一樣嘅，呢個就係你個 null 啦。咁個 alternative 就係 not all population mean are equal 啦。咁啊 ，alternative 嗰個意思係點解就可以睇翻上一條片啦，都有詳細講過嘅。嗱，咁我哋喺呢個 randomized block design 度咧， 係啦，用 ANOVA 其實就係要揾四樣嘢 ：SST、SSTR、SSBL 同埋 SSE。係啦，咁啊，比起completely randomized 咧，係複雜咗不少嘅。係啦，咁我哋首先就揾咗 SST 先。嗱，咁我哋就首先可以計咗呢個 overall sample mean 啦，就係 list 一二三十八個。係啦，十八個分加埋除十八啦。咁所以呢度嗰個 NT 咧就好明顯就係十八啦，因為我哋有十八個 observation 啦。咁我哋開始計之前咧，亦都可以幫每一個 block 嗱呢個 block one 計咗個 block mean 先啦。係啦，咁我哋因為有六個 block 就會有六個 block mean 啦。咁其實打橫加埋除三嘅啫。係啦，咁我哋都可以計埋每一個 treatment 嘅 mean 啊。咁 treatment A 嘅 mean 就係呢六個分加埋除六啦。係啦，咁啊應該冇乜問題嘅。咁 SST 係點計咧？係啦 ，SST 咧條式就係咁樣嘅 ，summation from i to 一 to b， 再 summation from j to 一 to k，xij 減 x 呢個 x double bar 嘅 square。咁呢條式咧睇落就好複雜啦，因為有兩個 summation。咁其實咧，我哋只不過將佢只需要將佢咧拆細咧，其實就唔好難。嗱，咁我哋首先就睇咗第一嚿 summation 先，咁啊 ，i 係 from 一 to b 啊嘛，咁 b 就係 total number of block， 即係有六個 block 啦。k 就 treatment 咯，三啦，咁咪首先 b 同埋 k 啊，搞翻掂佢係咩嚟嘅先。嗱，咁當 i 係等於一嘅時候，即係我哋第一個 block 嘅時候，嗱，咁啊 j 又係一啦，係啦，即係第一個 treatment 啦，咁啊八十四啦，係咪？八十四啦，減我哋嗰個 overall sample mean 咧就係八七點七二嘅 square， 再加好啦。咁我哋繼續啦。咁 j 等於一之後咧就係二啦，係咪？即係 block one 嘅第二個 treatment 啦，就係八十五啦。八十五減八七點七 square。咁其實都出嘅啦，跟住再。咁二係咁樣，一二三，一二三，如此類推。咁我哋就加加加加加，咁啊十八個 terms 應該就有。咁啊最尾個 terms 就係九啊一減八七點七二嘅 square 啦，就係呢度啦，搞到佢係啦。咁加埋曬佢咧，咁啊好快計一計咧就會計到七十一點六一。咁呢個就我哋嘅 SST sum of total sum of squares 啊。咁個 degree of freedom 就係 NT 減一啦，咁就係呢個 case 十八減一十七啦。咁啊 SST 就好複雜嘅，就唔難計咯，但係好複雜啦，因為要加減十八次，咁撳計數機就要小心啲啦。因為如果呢度計錯咗，咪之後揾 F statistic 咧，跟住要計嘅就係呢個 SSTR。SSTR 咧就同上一條片個計法有少少唔同，係啦，咁啊首先就睇到條式啦，條式就係咁樣嘅，係啦，咁 B 係咩咧 ？B 就 total number of block， 咁啊六啦真係，好啦，咁啊 J from 一條機 ，J 就係個 treatment 啊嘛，我哋睇翻，嗱咁 XIJ bar 係咩咧？嗱咁就 XI 一 bar 咧就係 treatment one 嘅mean 啦。係啦，即係八十七點三三啦。咁呢個我哋又知未？咁其實已經解決咗啦。咁就係其實咧 ，SSTR 就係每一個 treatment 嘅 mean 減我哋個 overall sample mean 嘅 square 啦。咁所以就八十七點三三減呢個八十七點七二 square 啦，加第二個啦，八十七點五減八十七點七二嘅 square 啦。再加埋第三個，八十八點三三減八七點七二 square 加埋曬佢，咁啊好快計一計又會計到三點四四啦。咁呢個 SSTR 嘅 degree of freedom 就係 k 減一啦。嗱，咁啊而家 k 咧就係同 total 有幾多個 treatment 啊嘛，係咪？所以就係三減一就係等於二啦。 咁啊，同樣地，我哋又可以計翻呢個 MSTR 啦，就係 SSTR 除個 degree of freedom 啦。咁所以我哋呢度好快又可以計計 3.44 除以3減1，咁咧就會計到咧 1.72 啊。我哋已經計到 SSTR 同埋 MSTR 啦。咁跟住就係要計 SSTL 啦。咁 SSTR 其實睇個 T 就係關 treatment 事嘅。SSBL 個 B 咧就係關個 block 事嘅。咁條式其實同 SSTR 調翻轉嘅啫。咁 K 就係 total 有幾多個 treatment 啊嘛，係咪？咁所以呢度個 K 就係3啦。咁啊乘以係啦。XIJ bar 係咩咧？我哋 I 係 from 一 to B 啊嘛，即係第一個就係 X1J 啦，係啦，咁即係第一個 block 嘅 mean 啦，就係84.67。其實 SSBL 要計嘅就係將每一個 sample mean 減翻個 overall mean， 係啦，再 take square 嘅啫。咁啊，好快寫出嚟啦，就係84.67減87.72 square 啦，第一個 block mean 減 overall sample mean 啦，第二個 block mean 就係86.67 減87.72 square 啦，再係咁加加加加加，入邊有六個 terms 啦，最尾就係90.67減呢個87.72嘅 square。咁我哋加埋曬呢六個 terms 再乘三咧，咁我哋就會計到SSBL 就等於64.28啦。咁 SSBL 嘅 degree of freedom 就係 B 減一啊嘛。咁 B 就 total 幾多個 block 啦？我哋就六個 block， 六減一就係等於5啦。係啦，咁啊又可以計呢個 MSBL 啦。咁只不過係 SSBL 除嗰個 degree of freedom 就係64.28除以六減一啦，即係除5啦，就係計到12.86噶啦。咁啊 ，SSE 咧今次就唔使將啲 sample 啊 variance 加嚟加去啦。咁我哋只不過係將 SSTL 減 SSTR，SST 減 SSTR 減 SSBL 咁就得啦。嗱，咁即係咧，我哋呢度就塞翻啲數落去啦。71.61減3.44減64.28咧，會計到3.89啦。咁啊，呢度個 degree of freedom 就複雜少少嘅 ，B 減一乘 K 減一。咁啊 ，B 減一就係等於 total block number 減一啦，六減一 ，K 減一就係 total treatment number 減一啦。咁所以就係五乘二咧，就係等於十啦。咁樣呢個 MSE 咧，亦都其實即係 SSE 除嗰個 degree of freedom 啫。大家應該都識點做噶啦，就3.89除以十，咁啊輕鬆啦，10.39。咁咧，我哋其實少少運算可以計到四個我哋想要嘅嘢啦 ，SST 啦，SSTR 啦，SSBL 啦，同埋 SSE 啦。咁跟住我哋就可以開始做我哋嗰個 test 啦。咁啊，同樣都用到 F test 嘅。咁我哋又 assume 我哋嘅 significance level 係 percent level。咁我哋個睇咗個 treatment 嘅 effect， 即係我哋睇下啊唔同嘅教學方法咧對考試成績嘅影響先。嗱，咁我哋就用 F test 啦，我哋就 reject H0 if F 就大過 F 嘅 significance level 嘅 critical value 啦。咁啊留意翻，雖然個 null 又好似等於咁，但係我哋又係唔使隨意嘅。嗱，成個睇曬就得噶啦，睇曬 right tail 就得噶啦。咁我哋計翻個 F statistic 先。咁我 F statistic 就係 MSTR 除 MSE 啦。咁我分子嘅 degree of freedom 就係 K 減一，分母個 degree of freedom 就係 K 減一乘 B 減一。嗱，咁其實就同就冇乜難度嘅啫。咁我哋又塞翻啲數落去啦。咁 MSTR 咧上高就係計到1.72啦，除呢個 MSE 啦，0.39啦。係啦，咁樣咧計一計就會計到4.41啦。咁跟住做 critical value approach 先。嗱，咁因為我哋個 significance level 係0.05啦，咁所以個 critical value 咧就係呢個啦。咁 Excel 咗用呢條式啊， 係啦，咁啊好快塞翻落去 Excel 度計一計啦，或者用其他 program 計啦，就會計到4.10嘅。係啦，咁啊喺呢個情況啦，因為 F statistic 大咗個 echo value， 咁所以咧 H 零咧個 null 就係 can be rejected 嘅。係啦，大家應該好熟悉噶啦。咁我哋塞翻個F statistic 嗰個數字落去啦，就係4.41啦。咁第一個 degree of freedom 就係分子呢個啦，二啦。第二個 degree of freedom 就係分母呢個就係十。咁咪塞翻落去計就會計到0.04。因為0.04咧係細過個 alpha， 即係0.05。咁啊，同樣 critical value approach 上咧 ，H 零都係 can be rejected 嘅。咁 H 零 can be rejected， 我哋嗰個 conclusion 係啲咩咧？個 conclusion 就係咧，係啦 ，different teaching methods 咧係會有呢個 effect on 我哋嘅 examination score， 即係唔同嘅教學方法咧，其實係會對考試分數造成一個影響嘅。咁啊，如果平時我哋做實驗，淨係想知 treatment effect， 即係咧啊，唔同教學方法對分數冇影響咧，其實我哋做到咁樣就得噶啦。呢、這個方法咧已經係將我哋嗰個 blocking 咧係 take 咗 into account 啦，係啦。即係我哋雖然係大家個 IQ 唔同啦，但係我哋呢個 ANOVA 嘅呢個做法咧就已經係將學生的 IQ take 咗 into account， 係啦，呢個 conclusion 係已經係 taken into account of 咧，學生有唔同嘅 IQ， 即係本身佢哋嘅資質係唔同嘅。我亦都得到一個結論，就係咧唔同教學方法的確係對呢個考試分數係有影響嘅。咁但係其實我哋而家咧可以做多一樣嘢，就睇埋個 block effect。咁啊個 block effect 個 null 就係啊 mu 一等於 mu 二等於 mu 六啦。咁呢個 mu 一係咩咧？就係第一個 block 嘅考試嘅 population mean 啦，即係 IQ 高係啦。第一個 block 就係 IQ 咧91到95嘅人啦，係啦，就係 population mean of 呢個 block 嘅人咧，就係等於第二個 block 嘅人等於第六個 block 嘅人，係啦。咁啊，其實簡單啲嚟講，即係咧個意思就係 IQ 係對考試成績冇影響嘅。咁我哋個 blocking effect 就可以透過呢個 ANOVA 呢個 randomized block design 去睇埋啦。咁同樣都係用 F test 去睇啦。咁啊 ，F test 就係 MSBL 除 MSE 啦。咁我哋其實頭先都計曬噶啦。咁就係12.86除以呢個0.39啦。咁啊，分子個 degree of freedom 就係 B 減一啦。B 減一就即係五啦。嗱，咁啊，分母個 degree of freedom 同頭先一樣添，都係 MSE 嘅，就係十啦。咁我哋咁樣計一計啦 ，F statistic 就好快會計到係呢個33。嗱，咁我哋又係睇 critical value approach 先。嗱，咁我哋 critical value approach 咧就可以用呢條式啦。但係今次嗰個 degree of freedom of one 係唔同咗嘅。我哋懟翻落 Excel 嗰度計一計啦，就會計到個 critical value 係3.33。嗱，咁樣 F statistic 33又大嘅 critical value。哦，呢個3.33啦，咁個 conclusion 就係 H 零咧 can be rejected 啦。咁我哋同樣都可以睇埋呢個 p value approach 嘅，係啦，咁啊 p value Excel 就用呢條式計啦，咁啊入翻正確嘅 degree of freedom 啦，再喺呢度寫翻個 F statistic 落去，咁我哋就可以計到咧。是等於大概零的 p-value， 因為 p-value 是零咧，就好明顯就係細過0.05啦。咁啊，同樣個 conclusion 就係 h 零都係 can be rejected 嘅。咁同 critical value approach 個 conclusion 都係一樣啦，就是零以外嘅。嗱，咁我哋個 conclusion 係乜嘢咧？就係、是、咧啊。即係你個 IQ 啊，係有冇對考試成績有冇影響咧？係 has effect on examination score。所以我哋可以見到其實每一個 block 嗰個 population meaning 都係唔同嘅，即係唔同 IQ 嘅人考試嘅 average score 應該都係會唔同嘅。我哋透過我哋呢個 F test 可以得知。咁我哋個 significance 就係 blocking variable IQ 咧都係有 effect on 個 examination score。咁呢樣嘢係更加我哋 justify 到點解我哋做呢個實驗嘅時候係要用呢個 randomized blocking design。而不用這個 completely randomized random 的 design， 因為我們是證實到即是看到 IQ 的確是對考試成績是有一個很大的 effect 的。但是這裡可以講一講的就是我們的結果只是知道 IQ 是對考試成績有影響，那常理上知道 IQ 越高應該考試成績越高，但我們透過這個實驗是不知道的，我們只知道 IQ 不同 IQ 在考試的時候會有不同的 result，就是这么多。咁啊 ，treatment effect 都是一样的，我哋都系唔知边个 treatment 系会对考试好啲嘅。我只系知道咧，唔同教学方法系会有呢个 impact on 呢个考试成绩嘅啫。咁呢条片就系讲咗 ANOVA 嘅第二个嘅 design 啦，叫 randomized block design。系啦，咁啊，我哋下条片再见啦，拜拜。